Battlefield to JR's three scams, soon to be five. And I know Jim's trying to spread out as much damage as she can. That's been tough. JR and Jim have about the same amount of eco right now, except, like I said, Viltdown slightly favoring Kim, so she just needs to keep this pressure up, but not invest too much more into the arches and then switch into actual economy. As 150 food gets dropped off immediately, three villages can be added in. Is that what the food's going to be spent on? Let's see. It is, it's three villages, so Jem is switching back into eco. Lames all of the deer as well. So, definitely not giving JR any time to breathe on this. I mean, she could range most of it, but with just feudal age arches, she wouldn't be able to reach, like, this part of it. She would only reach this, like, this part. So, it would still be safe. But yeah, right now he's pinned. He keeps idling those in the TC to keep him safe from these arches. I'm thinking as well, now that Jem's added in some eco, this could get scary. It's a Tetris mining camp. I'm not a fan. But there's worse things he could be doing right now when you consider everything that's going on in his face. And now using the Saracen bonus again, grouping the arches together, finally, I'm gonna start taking down some buildings. This is what I wanna see. Abuse that Saracen bonus as Jem's gonna come over and try cheekily take the gold. Realize maybe that's not really an option. No more villas on food. We have nethered farms at home. Onto stone instead. And it's gonna be another tower on the gold. Yeah, like you said, Gunnar, just keeping the JR pinned in so that he can't expand. Not letting him go anywhere, and killing that range is huge. And if she kills the second one as well, which she surely will, then there'll be no more scam production because JR doesn't have the wood for it. Yeah, now that this woodland's become pretty deep as well, I think you're right from the statements earlier too. The archers could range every villa tier now as well. A pretty solid tarty play from Jem. One village on food, so she's added in a farm. Or no, long pulling deer. Tati very strong. GG, says JR. You need to add the Tati to my arsenal. Very valiant defense from JR. He almost had it. He almost had it. The fight in this tower was really smart. And he almost had it. I think the big issue was when the barracks got denied by the scout. That was rough. Chef needs to learn that chef couldn't do this. I wish he could, but he couldn't. But Jem done it really well. Very solid performance. Yeah, I would have liked to have seen more building abuse with that Saracen bonus from Jem. But overall, very good tardy rush. JR done pretty much all he could. I think for me, JR, the only thing I would change. Oh, the only thing I would change is when the pre-mill gets denied. When the pre-mill gets denied, don't still do the pre-mill. You know what I mean? Like, it's being thwarted. Yeah, exactly. Like, well, once the pre-mill's been denied, it's being thwarted. Stop it, move on to something else. Because even if you do get it up, which you did, she's then waiting for it. Which, I mean, you went the wrong way, and by the time you got there, it was too late, and blah, blah, blah. But none of that really matters. Because that grayscale is always going to exist in AoE. But if your opponent stops you from doing something at a t when it especially when it's time based, yeah,